Children, they are just going on arguing that, see, they are concealing themselves. They are hiding to tell, they don't want to know that she doesn't want him to know that she is Lura, and Gonzalo doesn't want to tell that he is the same Gonzalo. So both are hiding their identification here, and they go on creating the story, which is an imaginary story of their own story, which they tell as if it is not true. And what we come to know is, here, after this telling of this story until now, they continue the story now. So, and here, Gonzalo has got a soft corner for Lura, where he tells, see, I know she is sitting beside me, but still, she is such an innocent person. She is entirely innocent, he gives the sentence. And Lura says, and what is, and was it you, by any chance, who told your cousin, that forget Lura? Is it you who had given the advice to your cousin to forget Lura? And Gonzalo says, why, my cousin never forgot. See, my cousin, he never forgot in his life Lura. Do you know what happened? How do you account then for his conduct? How can you say that, how can you tell surely that your cousin didn't forget Lura? So Gonzalo tells now, I'll tell you, the N man took refuge in my house when after the duel, and after few days, be fearing the consequences of the duel, that he may be caught by the police and put in a prison, he just because he was the merchant was very influential, that why he left my home and he went away to Sevilla, and then from there he traveled to Madrid. And my cousin wrote many letters to Lura, and some of them in poem forms, in verses, but undoubtedly they were intercepted by her parents. They were obstructed. These letters didn't reach Lura at all. The parent stopped giving, means they took away the letters which were written to Lura. So Lura didn't get the letters, but what happened here is the parents stopped the letters whichever came to Lura, and they didn't give her, and for she never answered them at all. So Gonzalo's letter never reached in the hand of Lura because her parents her parents took away the letters whichever were written to her. Then Gonzalo, what he does is, in despair, believing his love was lost for him forever, he joined the army of Spain, and he went to Africa, and there in a trench met a glorious death in that one of the wars which took place in Africa. What he does is, he met a glorious death grasping the flag of Spain, catching the flag of Spain in his hand, and while in his death also he was whispering the name of beloved Lura. So in the war, when the war took place, when he had been to Africa, he was he was catching the flag of Spain, but the last words which came out of his mouth before his death was his beloved. He was just having the name of Lura on his lips. And now Lura, she talks to herself, see what an cruel joke he is making, what a cruel lie, a shocking way of telling the lies. He is sitting beside me, but he is telling he met a glorious death. What a lie, what a cruel lie he is telling, what a way of telling this story and sitting alive beside me. And Don Gonzalo, to himself he tells, so for himself he tells, I could not have killed myself more gloriously, means I couldn't have killed myself, I could have made such a glorious death scene of my own. And he is very proud of making it, telling a lies like this to Lura. Now Lura tells, you must have been frustrated by the calamity or the disaster which happened, isn't it? So you might have been so much frustrated because your cousin died in such a situation in Africa. Yes, He says, "Yes, madam, or Senora, as if it were my own brother died there. I felt as if it was not my cousin, it was my own brother. And do you know what happened after that? Lura, in a very short time, see, my cousin died like that in Africa, fighting a war. And his last words from his mouth was the name of Lura. But do you know what Lura was doing, ma'am? She was just forgotten my cousin, and she was already, in a very short time, she was chasing butterflies in the garden, indifferent to the regret. Means she was, as usual, like girls take it very lightly, and she also forgot my cousin, and she was already spending her time according to her wish, and she was happily catching chasing butterflies in the garden, and she didn't have any regret for the love what she had lost." Now Lura says, "No, sir, no, no, Senora, no, sir, not like that. Do you know? Yes, it's a woman's way. See, women are all like that only," Gonzalo tells. But Lura says, "No, don't consider like that. Even if it were woman's way you are telling, the silver maiden was not of that disposition. She was not like that. See, my friend awaited the news of your cousin for nearly days and months and a year, but not even one letter came to her. And one afternoon, what she does in that despair, in that depression of not getting any letters for days, months or a year, she suddenly, what does is, just after one afternoon, just when the sun was setting, as the first stars appeared on the sky, she went to, somebody saw her leaving the house, and with quickening step, she walked very quickly away towards the beach which was nearby the bungalow. And when she went there near the beach, her beloved who had a fight there, and this was the memories which she had in her thing. This beach represented Gonzalo to her lover who fought for the sake of love. And there she sat down on a rock. And she sat there, her eyesight was fixed upon the horizon of the waves, and the waves were murmuring the sad song of a dead person. And she sat there, and slowly the waves came one upon the other, and where they came near the rock where the maid was, where this silver maiden was sitting, and the tides rose with such a boom or height that lastly the my cousin Lura also was washed away with the waves in the sea, and that's how she met her death. And Gonzalo said, "My God, is it so? Oh good God, heavens, does it happen?" And now Lura tells, "Do you know, the fishermen of that area who often tell the story confirm that it was a long time before the waves washed away, and even the name what she had written of Gonzalo was washed away in the sand after a few days. You will not get ahead of me." And now she tells to herself, "See, you might have decorated your death scene like that. You can't decorate more than what I have done. See, I have decorated my death scene a funeral in such a way, it can, mine can be the first, mine will be getting the first prize in decorating the funeral scene. So I may be sitting here, but I have told more descriptive way or more decorative way of the funeral scene." And Gonzalo now tells, "She lies worse than I do." See, what a lie. She is sitting beside me and she is telling her own death stories like this. And that isn't, she doesn't even know how to tell lies. And Lura tells, "Poor Lura, how she died." And here, poor Gonzalo, that is the cousin who was. And both of them go on talking like this. And after that, Lura tells to herself, "I will not tell him that I married 2 years after this." She doesn't want to disclose that after 2 years of this incident, she would have married some other person. And Gonzalo also doesn't want to tell. Gonzalo also doesn't want to tell that in 3 months' time, I ran off to Paris with a ballet dancer. So at least she would have waited for 2 years. This fellow wouldn't have waited for even 2 months. That he says, within 3 months of this duel incident, I fell in love with one of the ballet dancers, and I ran off with the ballet dancer to Paris. That's how he just confirms how much this story goes on. And now Laura says, Fate is curious. Fate is very curious. Here are you and I. See, fate, you just can't tell what is the fate. See, here you and I are sitting in a park, a complete strangers. Both we don't know each other. We are strangers, but we are met by chance. So our meeting was also by chance. And discussing the romance of somebody, of our old friends. And for a long ago, that also the story is such nearly 20, 30 years old story. We have been, suddenly we have met in by chance in a park. We are sitting on the same bench by chance. And we are going on discussing about our old friends and their romance. We have been conversing as if we were old friends. See, the way the conversation is going also, see, we are talking about as if we are very close friends. That's how we come to the end of this story. So today, children, I'll be ending this particular story till here, the sunny morning, and this is the end of part 4, and I'll be continuing the story in the next class. So thank you, children, for this. Thank you.